back to my channel, The Happy Mom. So today, friends, we are going to make one very easy to make DIY game for our kids, which will help them into learning alphabets. So for that, we require one box or any cardboard which you have at home, pair of scissors. So let's get started. First, we are going to cut this board into a rectangle or a square thing. I did not have a square one, so I'm using this rectangle one. You can use a square one if you have it at home. Use whatever stuff you have at home because we are trying to make best from waste. So now we'll cut all the sides and make it in a plane. Save these as well because we can also reuse this in some other activity. I never throw these cardboards or whatever stuff I have at home, because it always helps me in creating something good out of it. So just simply cut everything off. We just want the middle part. Using this rectangle one. If you don't want to use this, you can also use a square one like this. So now after this, we require some colorful paper. See, I have this sheet of colorful paper. This I have bought from Amazon. I will leave the link for this. So if you want to buy these similar ones, you can go through that link and you can buy it for yourself. These sheets are very useful for doing a lot of craft activity. I use this regularly for all my crafting work. So what I have done is I have torn these things into small pieces, and then you can take this. Simply take a paper, fold it into two. Now tear this from middle like this. Again fold it into two and again tear it. Since my board is small, so I'm using small ones. If your board is a little bigger, you can also use big ones. I am to again tear this like this, and now all I will do is take a little Fevicol and put it in one side. Just put it on the tip of the side and roll this. That is it. We have to make circles like this. I have already made and kept a few here so that I can show it to you as quick as possible and we don't waste time. So you can use as many colored papers as you have. The more colors, the more better. I am only using two different colors. One is and one is fluorescent yellow. So now let's get started. What you have to do is take this cardboard like this. Take these beautiful colored round circles which we have made now. Put a little glue, leave a little gap on above, and now stick these. Make sure you put proper and enough glue, because if the glue is less, there are more chances for it to come out. We will put alternate ones, one this side and one this side. There is no color coding, no color scheming. You can do it as in whatever way you wish and whatever color you wish to use. Like this, then again one on this side. This one we will do in two parts, since we are doing alphabets and there are 26 alphabets. So for 26 alphabets to make it in one board, it will be a little huge thing to do. So rather than doing that, what I do is whenever I do any alphabet activity with Manya, I usually break it into 13-13. So, and if there is enough space for doing 13 here, then you can do that, or else you stick as many as you have. Rest you can again make it later on in another cardboard. just remember these kids are small and they take time in learning, and if you do the same thing repeatedly, they'll get bored. So it is always wise to do activities in small installments, I call it. I have done this number board with her before and she simply loves it. She kept doing it for a week or two, but after that she got bored and she refused to even touch them. So now I have given her a break and now I'm making this alphabet one. So her interest should rise again. Like this, we have to make it in a pattern and keep sticking the noodle paper, that is what I call it. Simply just stick it. Stick this. That is all. This is all which is going to fit in this. If you don't want to make it in an alphabet, you can also use it for numbers. See, we have got something like this. You can also add 111 in middle, which we can do now, so that we can fit in more alphabets. You can use another colored paper also, that's not a problem. All 13 here now. This should be fine. Okay. This is what it looks like. Okay, so now since we have completed this, we are just going to take one colorful pen. You can also use multiple colors if you want to. I would be using blue and let's take another color as purple. Blue and purple we need. Now all we have to do is write the alphabet names. Like A. I am trying to teach her the capital letters, so I am going to write capital letters. If you are teaching small letters, please write small letters. A, then B. I am writing B in the middle one. You can write it anywhere you want. C. You can also write it before pasting, but I always somewhat prefer writing after I paste them, because I might stick it the other way and you know it is going to mess things up and I have to redo it again. So it's always safer to stick first and then write. We are going to add a lace to it. See, in bunch, and I have this lace here with me. I'm going to put this across this. Make the hole a little bit bigger because my lace is a little fat. You can use any lace. I have this shoelace at home, so I'm using this. And be very careful because if you tear it, it is going to come out very easily. So make sure you punch the hole a little lower than what where the starting is. Okay, so this thing I had, this big lace I had at home. So this is it. Now what the child has to do is simply first, you have to let this dry properly. So I am not going to put it inside now because if it doesn't dry, it will not hold the lace weight. So this will help you in teaching them alphabets from A to M, as I said. But this will also help them to learn which alphabet comes before which alphabet or after which alphabet. Like I teach Manya, tell me what comes before B, she can see A. What comes after B? C. Similarly, what comes after C? D. And what comes before C? B. This will help them to clear the concept about alphabets. Similarly, prior to this, I had made this board. This is for the numbers 1. You can see with the thing she has used it so many times. So from 1 to 10 this is there. I'll be replacing these from 11 to 20 now because she knows how to do 1 to 10 now. So in the similar way, this I had a square piece then, so I made it in a square one. I didn't have it this one currently, so I made it the rectangular one. So like this, she's going to put it inside A. Be very gentle. Actually, when the child will do, they don't usually put a lot of pressure. They are very gentle with it, so that will be a problem. And now B. This also, when they are putting in and pulling out, this is also very helpful for them because this helps in building the hand and eye coordination. See, like this shape. This goes into B, and what comes after B? C. Put it in C. In the C section. Similarly, again we will come on to D. What comes after D? What comes after C? D. It comes into the D section. The D section. What comes after D? E. And in the similar way, they can finish it till F. So I hope you enjoyed my best from waste activity. And whatever materials I used, links will be shared below so that you don't miss out on anything. This is all for now. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel and please spread a word about us because I am really glad and thankful that I've got such a wonderful audience who appreciate the work I do for them. So thank you so much. That is all for now. Keep watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Love you lots. Bye-bye.